All right, well, let's start with the debate last night. First of all, obviously, a lot of attention was brought with that video that was released on Friday. By your estimation, did Donald Trump do what he needed to do last night to change the conversation?
Yes, in some ways, yes. He hasn't changed the conversation in terms of that video and how people are responding to it, including, of course, your Senator Kelly Ayotte, who renounced her endorsement of Trump in the wake of that video. But he did change the conversation that was going on among Republicans about getting him off the ticket or trying to see how they could organize to oppose him. That seems to have stopped as a result of his credible performance in the debate.
So you don't think that there's any back channel communications going on to try to unite against Donald Trump, perhaps convince him to drop his bid for the White House and come up with some sort of write-in scenario where another candidate could take his place?
I don't think that's happening now because he did perform well enough last night. Now, that doesn't mean that there isn't another shoe to drop. I mean, this is a person who has had a microphone attached to his lapel for decades, and who knows what's out there. That's very worrisome to a lot of Republicans. So right now, what their tactic seems to be is to not abandon him, but not embrace him either. So run hard for the House and Senate and just see how he does.
Talk about the calculation that these down ballot candidates have to make. You mentioned Senator Ayotte. She cut loose of Donald Trump for the first time this weekend after having said that she wouldn't endorse him, but she'd vote for him. Now she says she won't vote for him at all. Help? Hurt? Is it break even?
Well, I think it would hurt her. I think she pretty much had to do it. You know your state better than I do, but it's not a place that women in New Hampshire would be particularly happy about those comments. And of course, she's running against a popular woman governor. So it's, she's been trying to find the right words to use about Donald Trump through this whole campaign. And it's been very hard for her, as it has been for a whole lot of people. And finally, she got to the point where her reaction was enough. In fact, Condoleezza Rice, the former Republican Secretary of State, used exactly that term, enough. She said somebody else should run. That's going to be very tough to do, as we said. And so I think that for somebody like Kelly Ayotte, what she says is, I'm cutting him loose and I'm just going on my own and hoping the people of New Hampshire know me and will elect me.
And Cokie, lastly, for those who haven't cut him loose, we have Governor Chris Sununu, governor's candidate Chris Sununu. We have obviously a couple of Republican candidates for Congress. One of them is incumbent, and they still are supporting, if not endorsing, Donald Trump. Is that a calculation that would seem to indicate that their fortunes will go as Donald Trump goes come November?
That could be the case. The Republican Party is going to, regardless of what happens, has gone through a tremendous convulsion. And if he loses in November, there's going to be an awful lot of trying to figure out where they go from here. And the people who stuck with him, even after this latest revelation, I think are going to have a lot of answering to do if, in fact, he does lose.
Cokie Roberts, thanks very much for joining us. Good to talk to you.
Always good to be with you.
Thank you, ma'am.